Hello there. My name is Minister Barton Aaron Porter, and today we're going to go into our Father's Word for another exciting Bible study. Now, I'm going to be using the good old King James Version of the Holy Bible, as I always do. So I encourage you to get your Bibles out and to study along with me. Let's approach our Heavenly Father's throne with a word of prayer before we get into this video. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we come with bowed heads and humble hearts, confessing our many sins, Lord, asking that you forgive us, wash us in the blood of Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, the Savior of the world. We put all our hope and trust in that precious blood he shed for us at Calvary, Lord. And we ask right now, Almighty God, that you fill us with your precious Holy Spirit as we go into your word, the Holy Bible. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we thank you, Almighty God, for hearing our prayer. Amen. Mark 10, verse 1, and he, that's Yeshua, arose from thence and comes into the coast of Judea by the further side of Jordan, the Jordan River, that is, and the people resort to him again, and as he was wont, W-O-N-T, what does that mean? It means it was his custom to serve the people. He taught them again. Verse 2, Mark 10, verse 2. And the Pharisees came to him and asked him, is it lawful for a man to put away his wife? Then it says, tempting him. Verse 3, and he answered and said to them, what did Moses command you? 4, and they said, Moses suffered to write a bill of divorcement and to put her away. And yes, Moses did do that. 5, and Jesus answered and said to them, he said, for the hardness of your heart, he wrote you this precept. Jesus says after that, in verse 6, but from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female. 7, for this cause shall a man leave his father and his mother and cleave to his wife. 8, and they twain, they too, that's what twang means when you look up that word twang. So he says, and they too shall be one flesh. So then they are no more two, but one flesh, as far as God is concerned. 9, what therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. What does the word asunder means? When you look up the word asunder, the Psalms Concordance, and it's a Greek word that means to place room between, that is part. So don't let nobody tear the man and the woman that God joined together in holy matrimony apart. That's what Jesus said. Verse 10, and in the house, his disciples asked him again of the same matters. 11, and he said to them, whosoever shall put away his wife and marry another commits adultery against her. 12, and if a woman shall put away her husband and be married to another, she committeth adultery. Here's the one thing that Mark didn't write in here that Matthew wrote in here, and we need. It's crucial. Matthew 19, verse 8-9. He said to them, Moses, because of the hardness of your heart, suffered you to put away your wives, but from the beginning it was not so. Here we go, verse 9, Matthew 19, 9. And I say to you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except, there we go, it be for fornication, and shall marry another committeth adultery, and whoso marry her which is put away does commit adultery. So that one little phrase right there changes everything. If you divorce your spouse for any reason other than fornication and went and got married again, you are committing adultery. Mark 10:13. And they brought young children to him that he should touch them. And his disciples rebuked those that brought them. So they brought all the little babies to the rabbi because they wanted him to lay hands on the babies and bless them. 14. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased. The disciples were telling the women to go away. Don't bring those little brats over here. Leave the master alone. Jesus said, suffer the little children to come to me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. I want y'all to get this. The children possess qualities that you and I have to possess. Children are very humble and teachable. Little kids. I love kids. Verse 15, verily means surely, which is the same as truly. Surely I say to you, whosoever will not receive the kingdom of God as a little child shall not enter therein or into it. 16, and he took them up in his arms. He picked the babies up. He took them up in his arms, put his hands upon them, and blessed them. Not only did he say, bring the babies over here, he gave them a big hug. All right, Mark 10:17. And when he was gone forth into the way, there came one running and kneeling to him and asked him, good master, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life? 18, and Jesus said to him, why do you call me good? There is none good but one, that is God. Now let's deal with that first. Jesus is God. Amen. Jesus is good. Amen. Jesus never, ever sinned. Ever. The Bible says he knew no sin, he did no sin, and in him was no sin. So why did he tell the man, why you call me good? There's only one good God, referring to the Father. Why did he do it? Okay, let's find out. Turn to Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. The apostle writes there, let this mind be in you, let this mentality be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, which was also in our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. 6, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. He didn't think it was robbery to be considered equal with God because he is God. 7, look, but made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. That's why he said to the man, why are you calling me good? There's nobody good but God. And when he came in the first advent, he didn't come to be worshiped as God Almighty. He came to suffer and die for us at Calvary. He came as the suffering servant. So he was very humble. Mark 10, verse 19. He said, you know the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Y'all hold up one finger, even though I can't see it. That's one of them. Thou shalt not commit adultery, or you will not commit adultery, is one of the Ten Commandments. Do not kill. Hold up another one. That's two. You will not kill. Thou shalt not kill is the second commandment. Do not steal. Hold up three fingers. You shall not steal. Thou shalt not steal. A third commandment. Do not bear false witness. That's a fourth commandment. Don't be lying on people.
He says, do not defraud. Then he says, honor your father and your mother.
Mark 10:20.
And he answered and said to him, Master, all these I have observed from my youth. 21, Jesus, beholding him, loved him and said to him, one thing you lack. He didn't say, no, boy, you ain't been keeping no commandments. He said, there's one thing you lack. He says, go your way, sell whatsoever you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven, and come take up the cross and follow me. Now, we're going to deal with the one thing that he lacked. What is the one thing he lacked? Well, the Bible makes it very clear the one thing he lacked is a relationship with God. The money was his God. That's why Christ didn't quote the first couple of commandments. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Thou shalt not make any graven images of anything in heaven above or on earth or underneath earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself and worship them. He didn't quote the first four commandments because that money was his God. That money is who he worshiped, and he was too dumb to know it. It was proven because after Christ told him to get rid of his false God and come follow me, the real God, verse 22, it says that he was sad at that saying and went away grieved, for he had great possessions. You see that? He wasn't about to give up his God. Oh, no. 23, and Jesus looked round about and said to his disciples, how hardly shall they that have riches enter into the kingdom of God? 24, and the disciples were astonished at his words, but Jesus answered again and said to them, children, how hard is it for them that trust in riches to enter into the kingdom of God? 25, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. You see that, saints? The money was his God. Verse 26, Mark 10, and they were astonished out of measure, saying among themselves, who then can be saved? And that's how people are to this day. They are really impressed with people who have a lot of wealth. And they think, oh, man, they made it. They're on top of the world. They're so powerful. Jesus said it'd be easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter into the kingdom of heaven. 27, and Jesus looking upon them said, with men, it is impossible. He answered the question. He said, who can be saved? If the rich can't be saved, who can be saved? He said, with men, it's impossible, but not with God. For with God, all things are possible. Amen? Mark 10:28. All right. Then Peter began to say to him, lo, which means behold, we have left all and followed you. 29, and Jesus answered and said, surely or truly, I say to you, there is no man, I'm going to add woman too, there's no man or woman that has left house or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my sake and the gospel's, 30, but he or she shall receive 100-fold now in this time. Don't read over that. Now in this time. Houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands and persecutions, and in the world to come eternal life. He says in verse 31, but many that are first shall be last, and the last shall be first. Now let's deal with this. The Bible says in all you're getting, get an understanding. Jesus said in verse 30,
but he or she will receive a hundredfold now in this time. Houses, plural, and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands. Notice persecutions come with it. Some people say, well, Minister Porter, I've given my life to Jesus and I serve him every day. I ain't got no bunch of houses and lands and stuff. What are you talking about? Oh, yes, you do. Any real Christian, listen to me, church, knows that what God has blessed him with is not just for him. Any real Christian knows that whatever God has blessed him with is to be shared with all true believers. Okay? You brothers and sisters have houses and lands right now. Yes, you do. You are my brother and sister in Christ, who I love. I'm a real Christian. I'm not no phony. And y'all know that. If any one of y'all come to me with a need, and I can help you, it's a done deal. This is what he's talking about. I gave away so much money this year, I should be committed to an institution to have my head examined. And I ain't got no money. So this is what he's talking about. Real Christians know the things that God has blessed them with is not for them. It's for everybody who is their brother or sister in Christ. And sometimes it's for people who are not their brother and sister in Christ. There are times when God will direct you to take your blessings that he gave you and bless the poor. Amen? Now let's wrap it up. 32. Mark 10, 32. And they were in the way going up to Jerusalem, and Jesus went before them, and they were amazed. And as they followed, they were afraid. And he took again the 12 and began to tell them what things should happen to him. 33, saying, behold, we go up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man shall be delivered to the chief priests and to the scribes, and they shall condemn him to death and shall deliver him to the Gentiles. He's trying to get them ready for what he came to do, was to die as the Lamb of God who took away our sin. He's trying to prepare them mentally and spiritually because they didn't understand it. 34, and they shall mock him. That means they're going to make fun of me. They shall scourge him. That means they're going to beat me with a cat of nine tails. Going to tear my flesh. And they shall spit upon him. They're going to spit in the face of the Son of God. And shall kill him. They're going to kill the Son of God. Listen. And the third day he shall rise again. Mark 10, 35. And James and John, the sons of Zebedee, come to him saying, Master, we would that you should do for us whatsoever we shall desire. So he's constantly trying to tell them what he's about to do to save them. And look what these fools come up with. Master, we want you to do something for us. 36. And he said to them, what would you that I should do for you? What do you want? 37. And they said to him, grant to us that we may sit on your right hand and the other on your left hand in your glory. He's telling them what he's about to do to save them. And all these yo-yos can come up with is what position they want in the kingdom. Pathetic. Pathetic. 38. But Jesus said to them, you know not what you ask. He says, can you drink of the cup that I drink of and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with? He says, are you able to do what I'm about to do for you? In other words, 39, and they said to him, we can. And Jesus said to them, you shall indeed drink of the cup that I drink of, and with the baptism that I am baptized with, you shall be baptized. Verse 40, but to sit on my right hand and on my left hand, it's not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared. He said, you're right. You sons of Zebedee, John and James, they gonna do you just the way they did me. But where you gonna sit in my kingdom, that ain't up for me. That's up to the Father. 41 says, and when the 10 heard it, they began to be displeased with James and John. They're like, you big dummy. He's telling you that he's about to go down there and get tortured and butchered and killed. And all y'all can worry about is what position y'all gonna have in the kingdom. They should have been mad at him. 42, but Jesus called them to him and said to them, he stopped this foolish argument. He says, you know that they which are counted to rule over the Gentiles exercise lordship over them. I want y'all to get this. And their great ones exercise authority upon them. You know how it is in the unsaved world. People with authority have a complex that they're important. That's what he's saying. He says in verse 43, but so shall it not be among you. It's not supposed to be that way among the followers of Jesus Christ. But whosoever will be great among you shall be your minister. I want y'all to get this. 44. And whosoever of you will be the chiefest shall be servant of all. 45. For even the Son of Man came not to be ministered to, but to minister and to give his life a ransom for many. Now, I want y'all to get this. Christ said, so you want to be great? You have to be everybody's servant. Everybody's servant. It's not like in the world when the man with authority is up there waiting for somebody to be his servant. But no, you are to be everybody's servant. Verse 46. And they came to Jericho, and as he went out of Jericho with his disciples, a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. 47. And when he had heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry and say, Jesus, you son of David, have mercy on me. 48. And many charged him that he should hold his peace. They told him, shut up! Be quiet! But he cried the more, a great deal, you son of David, have mercy on me! 49. And Yeshua stood still and commanded him to be called. He said, go get him. And they called the blind man to him, be of good comfort, rise, he calls you. They went to blind Bartimaeus and said, Yeshua wants you to come over there. 50, and he casting away his garment rose and came to Yeshua. He threw down his garment, which he needed to keep him warm, and he's a blind man, but he knows who he's coming to. He knows through the Spirit that he's coming to the Son of God, the one who can save him.
51. And Yeshua answered and said to him, "What wilt thou that I should do unto thee?" What do you want me to do for you, in other words? The blind man said to him, "Lord, that I might receive my sight." 52. This is the last verse. And Yeshua said to him, "Go your way. Listen, your faith has made you whole." And immediately he received his sight and followed Yeshua in the way. If this particular Bible study has been a blessing to you, and you want to bless me with a love gift of any amount, this is how you can do that. Go to paypal.com, download the PayPal app. It's free. Then you would use this code to send me your love gift. paypal.me/Bartron Porter. You can also download the free Cash app. My code is cash.app/$10.14. And then there are people who prefer Zelle. For Zelle, all you need is my name, Barton Porter, and my phone number, which is 630-441-4563. Now, here are non-financial ways you can be a blessing to yours truly and this ministry. I need your prayers, saints. Pray for Minister Porter and pray for this ministry. And share the Bible study videos. If you're being blessed or encouraged or taught through this ministry, share these Bible study videos with as many people as possible. And if you have any Bible questions or prayer requests, you can call me at 630-441-4563. I live in Illinois, so I'm in the Central Time Zone. And if you don't have a phone, you can email me, BartonAaronPorter@gmail.com. I need you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please hit the subscribe button. It does not cost you a penny. And underneath the video also, after you hit the subscription button, there's a little bell icon. Click on that bell icon. That bell is the notification icon. Every time a video is released, you will get a notification. And underneath the video, there's two thumbs, one up, one down. If you like my video, if you like the content, please take the time to hit that thumbs up button. And please take the time to put something in the comment section. Now, these shirts that you see me wear all the time are my own designs. I have an online t-shirt store. It's godwear.store. So please check out the t-shirts, the hoodies, the women tees, the cups. If you see something you like, buy it, because you're getting something that you can use to share the gospel of Jesus Christ everywhere you go. And you're also blessing this ministry as well. So, until next time, this is Minister Barton Aaron Porter saying, may the good Lord continue to bless you and keep you all the days of your life. God bless you and goodbye.